When you're solving PDEs using separation of variables, one of the first techniques you will learn, you often end up with series in terms of the cosine of x, cosine of 2x, etc. And expanding in terms of this set of functions, 1, cosine x, cosine 2x, is actually very convenient, because if you define your inner product correctly, this will become an orthogonal set, which means that you will be able to use easy projection formulas to get the coefficients in front of your cosines. But why is this set of cosines orthogonal, and how should you choose your inner product? Well, that is what you will learn in this video. So, we take our set S, 1, cosine x, cosine 2x, etc. up till infinity. And then we define our inner product again as an integral, and we integrate from 0 to pi. So our integral will be integral from 0 to pi, fx, gx, dx. And then we say, well, let's write fm as cosine of mx and fn as a cosine of nx, just as a notation to be able to write things up a bit shorter, where m and n are both positive or 0. So let us see what happens if we compute the inner product between fm and fn. So if we compute the inner product between two members of our set S using this inner product over here. So we have the inner product of, we will need to compute the integral of cosine mx times cosine nx. How can you find the antiderivative of that? Well, fortunately, we know some trigonometric rules. We know cosine a plus b equals cosine a cosine b minus sine a sine b, this rule over here. And you can also apply that if you substitute minus b on the spot of b. Then you get cosine a cosine minus b, which is the same as cosine b, minus sine a sine minus b, but the sine of minus b equals minus sine of b, so that gives a plus sign over there. And then we can do a neat trick. If we add those two here together, then the signs drop out, and we get 2 times the cos a cos b on the right hand side, and on the left hand side we get cosine a plus b plus cosine a minus b. And this formula will help us to evaluate integrals of the form cosine mx times cosine nx, because it will allow us to write them as one cosine. That's what we are going to do. Integral from 0 to pi, cosine mx, cosine nx, cosine a times cosine b equals 1 half cosine a plus b plus 1 half cosine a minus b. So that's what we do here. 1 half can go in front. Cosine a plus b, cosine mx plus nx, cosine a minus b, cosine mx minus nx. Then you can take the m plus n in front of the x, over here and over there. And then you have just integrals of the form cosine, cosine of a multiple of x. And you can find antiderivatives of that. The cosine of m plus nx, if you integrate, yields the sine of m plus n times x divided by n plus n. And similarly for the cosine of m minus n of x. However, be careful. This only holds as long as you're not dividing by 0. So as long as if m is not equal to n. Over here, you're always fine, because m plus n is something positive, that part is fine, but the other one, that one is dangerous. There you have to take care. Well, but if m is not equal to n, then you can just plug in x equals 0, so you get sine of 0, which is 0, or you can plug in x equals pi, you get m plus n times pi, which is multiple of pi, and sine of a multiple of pi is also 0. So you see that actually this integral over here is 0 quite a lot of times. Only if m is not equal, only if m is equal to n, the integral is non-zero, and if m is not equal to n, the integral will be equal to 0. So that's summarized over here. Integral inner product fm, n, fn equals 0 if m is not equal to n. And if they are both equal, then you can also compute the inner product. That turns out to be pi over 2. So you can summarize those two results into one equation. inner product fm, fn equals pi over 2 times delta mn. Delta mn is defined as to be 1 if m equals n and 0 if m is not equal to m. And so we see that our original set is in fact a so-called orthogonal set, because inner products of a member with one of the others, those inner products are always 0.